Welcome to Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S., Financing Healthcare Part 2. This is Lecture C. The component, Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S., is a survey of how healthcare and public health are organized and how services are delivered in the U.S. It covers public policy, relevant organizations and their interrelationships, professional roles, legal and regulatory issues, and payment systems. It also addresses health reform initiatives in the U.S. The objectives for Financing Healthcare Part 2 are to describe the revenue cycle and the billing process undertaken by different healthcare enterprises, explain the billing and coding processes and standard code sets used in the claims process, identify different fee-for-service and episode of care reimbursement methodologies used by insurers and healthcare organizations in the claims process, review factors responsible for escalating healthcare expenditures in the U.S., and discuss methods of controlling rising medical costs. This lecture discusses the high cost of healthcare services in the U.S., including U.S. healthcare expenditures and medical inflation, and the factors that contribute to the increasing healthcare expenditures in the U.S. It also describes the Emergency Medical Treatment and Active Labor Act, or EMTALA, its provisions for care for the uninsured, and its potential contribution to increasing medical costs. Finally, this lecture details the cost of care for the uninsured. The factors that contribute to higher healthcare expenditures include technology, increased demand for and utilization of healthcare due to chronic disease and the aging population. This results in rising hospital and physician costs, as well as increased pharmaceutical demand and cost. In addition, administrative costs account for approximately 7% of healthcare expenditures in the U.S., twice the average of other industrialized countries. The Congressional Budget Office, or CBO, estimates that almost one-half of the healthcare expenditures in the U.S. are due to the cost of technology. The CBO refers to technology in healthcare as the procedures, equipment, and processes used in the delivery of healthcare services. Over the years, technology has led to advances in medicine that have prolonged the life expectancy of the average person. Previously untreatable conditions, along with new medical and surgical procedures, have permitted individuals to survive conditions that, if not fatal, were debilitating. For example, arthritis in hips and knees, which created mobility issues for people, can now be treated with hip and knee replacements that allow individuals to continue an active lifestyle for many years. Artery blockages in the heart can now be treated with angioplasty, resulting in increased survival rates for illnesses that previously proved fatal. At the same time that technology permits individuals to live longer, the improved survival rates place additional pressure on the healthcare system through increased demand and utilization of services. Medical imaging equipment, such as computerized tomography or CT scanners, and magnetic resonance imaging or MRI equipment permits physicians to look inside the body and create a picture of the damage resulting from an injury or illness. Despite the high cost of purchase and operation, easy availability of these devices increases utilization. Medical devices such as implantable defibrillators permit survival and treatment of life-threatening heart rhythms. In the next few years, the government will invest billions of dollars in health information technology to aid in the delivery of high-quality, cost-efficient care and the sharing of information among providers, especially via electronic medical records or EMRs. Telemedicine will become ubiquitous. Already, an X-ray taken digitally at a hospital or a remote clinic can be transmitted to a radiologist in another state or country for interpretation. New technology has permitted the pharmaceutical industry to develop new medications for the treatment of disease. Pharmaceutical costs are estimated to be approximately 10% of the total healthcare expenditures annually. These costs have increased sevenfold since 1990. During the last decade, pharmaceutical costs have increased annually by an average of 12% per year, far exceeding the consumer price index and inflation in other healthcare sectors. Part of these costs relate to increased utilization and demand for medications to treat terminal or chronic disease. For example, medications to treat illnesses and conditions such as diabetes, HIV, and elevated cholesterol have increased survival. Yet, at the same time, this may lead to increased utilization of healthcare services and newer, more expensive medications, which will ultimately drive up healthcare costs. Another example involves the demand for new drugs, such as cancer chemotherapy, that may increase survival by only a few months, but may cost many times more than established treatments. Administration costs are estimated to contribute to approximately 7% of the total healthcare expenditure in the U.S. A study by the McKinsey Global Institute found that administrative costs account for more than twice the average spent by other industrialized nations and contribute $91 billion annually in excess healthcare expenditures in the U.S. Along with new technology, increased demand and utilization also contributes to increased hospital and physician costs. Hospitals may wish to improve their competitive standing and enhance the reputation of their facility in the community by purchasing the latest equipment and offering related services. In addition, there may be increased demand for specific devices or services by both providers and patients. Some examples include imaging techniques such as positron emission tomography, referred to as the PET scan, magnetic resonance imaging or MRI, and da Vinci robotic surgery. It has been argued that although these technologies are expensive, increased utilization of these devices and techniques can improve quality and reduce costs through their advanced diagnostic capabilities, or by reducing complications and shortening length of stay. However, the increase in demand for both hospital and physician services and the concomitant increase in costs may offset any savings. Care and treatment of individuals with chronic disease constitutes a large portion of the expenditures on healthcare in the U.S. Chronic diseases are ongoing, generally incurable illnesses or conditions such as heart disease, obesity, cancer, and diabetes. These diseases are often preventable and frequently manageable through early detection, improved diet, exercise, and medical treatment. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, estimate that as of 2012, approximately 1 out of 2 adults had at least one chronic disease, and that 7 out of the top 10 causes of death were due to chronic disease. The CDC estimates that 1 of every 4 individuals has limitations in daily activities as a result of their chronic disease. The CDC also points out that obesity is a contributor to chronic disease and is rapidly becoming a major health concern and a source of increased healthcare expenditures. The CDC identifies 4 health risk behaviors that contribute to the development and increase of chronic disease, including the lack of physical activity, poor nutrition and obesity, tobacco use, and excessive alcohol consumption. Many of these activities have been linked to other illnesses, such as alcohol consumption and smoking, with various types of cancer, and poor nutrition and obesity with diabetes, heart disease, and high blood pressure. This slide lists the most prevalent chronic diseases in the U.S., many of which are preventable and/or manageable. Other than mood disorders and senility, obesity and smoking are major contributors in the development of 7 of the 9 chronic illnesses listed and considered preventable. Care for chronic illness requires increased utilization of healthcare services and resources. Management of chronic illness attempts to prevent further deterioration of the condition, maintain a satisfactory state of health and well-being, and decrease the risk of developing complications. For example, aggressive control of blood sugar can avoid damage to small blood vessels that could lead to heart disease, kidney failure, or blindness. In addition, early intervention with at-risk groups such as smokers or the obese may increase spending and utilization, but have the potential to result in lower long-term costs. Additional resources are spent in the early detection and prevention of illness, for example, using screening mammograms to detect breast cancer or immunizations to prevent infectious disease. The increase in the incidence of chronic disease associated with the aging of the population and the subsequent demand for medical services is expected to contribute significantly to the increase in healthcare expenditures in the U.S. in the coming years. There is increased cost after age 64. 66 million children were born between 1946 and 1964, a group called baby boomers, and the oldest of the group became eligible for Medicare in 2011. Projected national healthcare expenditures per capita are expected to rise above $13,000, with much of the burden due to Medicare costs associated with the baby boomers' increased utilization of healthcare services. In 2009, the number of uninsured rose to approximately 50 million people, or 1/6 of the population. In general, the uninsured receive less preventive care, are diagnosed at a more advanced disease state because of delay in seeking treatment, receive less therapeutic care due to high costs of treatment after being diagnosed with an illness or chronic disease, and have higher mortality rates. The cost for care at a more advanced disease state is twice as much for the uninsured compared to the insured individual with the same disease. Under the ACA, as of 2014, Medicaid coverage eligibility has expanded to include nearly all adults with incomes at or below 138% of the federal poverty level, although not all states have elected to adopt the Medicaid expansion. Tax credits are also available for people who purchase coverage through a health insurance marketplace. Millions of people have enrolled in these new coverage options. Cost still poses a major barrier to coverage for the uninsured. In 2014, 48% of uninsured adults said that the main reason they lacked coverage was because it was too expensive. Eligibility is also a barrier. 12% of uninsured adults mentioned work-related reasons, such as being unemployed or not having an offer through work, and 13% said they were told they were ineligible or could not get coverage due to their immigration status. The Emergency Medical Treatment and Active Labor Act, or EMTALA, is a federal law that requires hospitals to provide emergency medical care to patients regardless of their ability to pay. Anyone presenting to an emergency room requesting evaluation for an illness must be examined to determine if there is an emergency, treated until stabilized if there is one, and discharged to self-care or continuing care. If the hospital is unable to provide the care at its facility, then the patient must be transferred to a facility able to provide the care. It is often believed that the uninsured account for overcrowding and use of an excessive amount of services through the emergency department, or ED, under the EMTALA Act. However, in 2008, Weber published a retrospective study and found that the percentage of uninsured using the emergency department did not change over 10 years. The research found that most of the increase was due to non-poor insured with a primary care physician as their usual source of care using the ED for non-urgent care. A 2009 Robert Wood Johnson study found that the lack of key ED staff is the primary cause of overcrowding, and not overuse by the uninsured or for treatment for non-urgent conditions. This overcrowding is associated with a decrease in quality of care, longer waiting periods for care in the ED, and reduced patient safety. This concludes Lecture C of Financing Healthcare, Part 2. In summary, the U.S. has the highest per capita national healthcare expenditures and the highest national healthcare expenditures as a percentage of GDP in the world. Factors driving costs include increased demand and utilization due to aging and chronic disease, technology, pharmaceutical costs, and high administration costs. Contrary to popular perception, the EMTALA Act has not increased utilization of the emergency department by the uninsured. Information from a study published in 2008 suggests that the percentage of uninsured using the emergency department, ED, did not increase significantly over a 10-year period. Rather, there was an increase in utilization of the ED by insured individuals with a normal source of primary care. The total cost of care for the uninsured is approximately 7% of all healthcare expenditures. In general, the uninsured receive less care and treatment for chronic disease and acute illness, are sicker when they seek care, and have a higher mortality rate. The challenge of the healthcare delivery system is to reduce or slow costs, maintain quality of care, and improve outcomes and accessibility to care.